In today's video, we're going to talk about the binomial distribution. Now first, let's start to think about the following systems and tell me what these have in common. If you flip a coin, if you're sitting an exam, or if you have a quality assurance for a manufacturing plant, what are the things that these outcomes have in common? Well, if you think about flipping a coin, you can either get heads or tails. If you think about sitting an exam, you can either pass or fail it. And then if you think about quality assurance at a manufacturing plant, you can also just pass or fail that assessment. So all of these are example of binary events where there are only two possible outcomes, right? So these are all of our possible outcomes that we've talked about. What we're going to do is when we're looking at the binomial distribution, we're going to be evaluating binary events where there's only two possible outcomes. We need to remember first what a probability distribution is, right? Because the binomial distribution is an example or one of many probability distributions. All of our outcomes are paired with their probabilities. We have two different types of probability distribution. We can look at data that are discrete or continuous. And for our example today, binomial distribution is going to be looking at the probability distribution of different outcomes of repeated binary events. So what I want you to keep in mind is in order to look at binomial distribution, we first need to have binary events. So we need to have two possible outcomes. We're often going to call these two possible outcomes a success and a failure. Everything needs to be independent trials. So for example, flipping a coin, we're going to be flipping the coin, let's say 50 times. Every time we flip the coin, it's independent of the time we flipped before. And then the probabilities of success is the same every time that we try the trial. So for flipping a coin, every time we flip it, we have the same probability 50% of getting heads. Looking at this spinner here on the top left, you see there's two options of what you could fall on. You could fall on a white or you can fall on a blue. The probabilities of each of these, the white, you would have a probability of a fourth of falling on it. And then the blue, you'd probably have a probability of 3/4 falling on it. This is an example of a binary event. And since you're getting only blues or white, let's think about you spinning the spinner three times and you record what color you get. What is the maximum number of blue you could get? Well, if you're spinning the spinner three times, the maximum number of blues you could get would be three. But what is the minimum number of blues you could get? Well, in this situation, if you spin the spinner three times, you could get white every single time. So in this binary event, we are repeating the experiment three times, and we can have the outcomes from 0 to 3 for the number of blues that we're getting. Okay, well, we can show this using a tree diagram as we're used to doing in our previous probability questions. So if I spin the spinner one time, I can get either blue or white. I spin it a second time, I get again blue or white, and then I continue until I spin it three times. And then we see our possible outcomes here. We can get three blues. In red, we have the outcomes of getting exactly two blues. In yellow are the outcomes of getting exactly one blue. And then we have in green the outcome of getting no blues at all. And then we know how to calculate these probabilities, right? We go along our branches and we multiply our probabilities together, right? So blue, blue, white, we're going 3/4 × 3/4 × 1/4. And we can calculate all of these probabilities together. I know that all these probabilities here add up to 1. And then I can ask myself, okay, what is the probability of getting exactly 2 blues? Well, exactly 2 blues, that means it's all the red together. So we're adding up the probability of blue, blue, white, blue, white, blue, and white, blue, blue. So what I can do is I can ask myself, okay, what is the sum of these probabilities? So if I look at the probability of getting 3 blues, I would get 0.421. And if you would look for the probability of getting exactly 2 blues, you add up these red ones together, you would actually get the same number, coincidence. And then if you add up the yellows, you would get this probability. And then the final one, you would get this probability here. So what we're realizing is that with our binomial event, we're doing it three times, we're realizing that there's 4 different possible outcomes, 0, 1, 2, or 3 amount of blues. These probabilities add up to 1 because it's a probability distribution. There's a different way that I could represent these probabilities. I could decide to create a table such as this, where X is the number of blues I'm getting, And I see the probabilities here. This is the probability of getting 0 blues, 1 blue, 2 blue, and 3 blues. This is an example of a probability distribution graph where we have 3 trials, and the probability of success is 0.75. In our case, success was the blue, right? So what's the probability of getting blue in one spin? 0.75. What we'll be using is the binomial distribution to solve questions about repeated number of trials. Imagine I could be doing this trial more than 10 times, 50 times, 100 times. Every time you do a trial, that's your tree diagram increasing, right? So you don't want to have to do this tree diagram for 10 spins, right? So what we're going to do instead is we're going to be using this binomial distribution with our GDC, and the binomial distribution will give us the values of these probabilities together. Okay, so what I want you to keep in mind when you're doing these questions is that the numbers that the calculator are giving you represent you doing a tree diagram, adding up all the probabilities together. That is the number that the calculator will be giving to you. It's a very complex calculation, but that we're going to let the calculator do for us. How is the calculator going to do this for us? Well, there's two different modes that we're going to be using in the calculator, and I'll show you how to use your calculator soon. Binomial PDF, that's going to be to calculate the probability of exactly one number occurring. And then for binomial CDF, this is going to be the summation of various probabilities, so adding up more than one value together. Your calculator can only go from zero all the way to the number you input it in. Again, I will make sure that we understand this through the examples we do today. Let's look at our first example. It is given that 45% of population of a large city supports the efforts of the mayor for a revision of the healthcare system. If a random poll of 20 people who live in the city is taken and all 20 people give an answer, then what is the probability that exactly 5 people support the healthcare revision? Okay, so for this question, I'm going to ask you to take out your calculator.
So if we think about the situation, we're asking 20 people whether they're supporting or not the healthcare system. The fact that they can either support or not support, that makes it a binary event. And then we know that the probability of each person supporting is 0.45. So we have a binary event. We have the probability of each individual supporting. And we know that we're repeating this 20 times with 20 different people. So if we think about the outcomes, we have a total of 20 people who could be supporting. And then we could also have 0 people who could be supporting, right? So our outcomes are everything between 0 and 20. So this is the probability distribution graph that is linked with 20 trials and a probability of success of 0.45. What is the probability that exactly 5 people support the healthcare revision? For exactly 5 people, I'm looking for what is the probability of having this bar here, exactly 5 people. Well, let's ask our calculator how to do that. In your calculator, you're going to go into second function vars. That's going to be all the distributions. And you're going to scroll down until you find binomial. Notice that we have our two options for binomial, PDF, CDF. PDF is when we're looking for one value. So this is the case here. I'm looking for exactly one value. The number of trials, this is how many people I have. The probability of success, P, is 0.45. And the X value, right now I'm interested in getting exactly 5 people. So I'm going to get that the probability of having exactly 5 people support the healthcare system would be 0.0365 if you round it to 3 significant figures. Okay, let's look how this is different to part B. Part B, what is the probability that at most 6 people support the healthcare revision? At most 6 people. That means it's a maximum of 6 people, and we don't want it to be more than that. So we're looking for the probability that we could have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So we're actually adding up all the columns from 0 all the way to 6. Now, it seems like there's no probability here because the probability of having 0, 1, or 2 people is so low that you can't really visualize it on the graph. But there's still some things here. Same as from 16 to 20, there are still some probability bars here, but they're just so low that it's hard to visualize on the graph. So what we're interested in, like we said, is from 0 all the way to 6. What I could do is I could ask my calculator to do each of the probabilities individually and then add them together. I would have to do the 0, the 1, the 2, 3, on all the way to 6 and add them together. But that's a little bit tedious. So instead of doing that, we're going to use our calculator and we're going to use the function binomial CDF. So we're going to go second function vars, and instead of using PDF, we're using CDF. Now notice that the platform looks exactly the same as the question we did before. The only difference is now we have CDF. The number of trials has not changed and our probability of success have not changed. When you're doing CDF, you always have to realize that we're doing from the value of 0 all the way to whatever value you are including in here. So I'm interested from 0 all the way to 6 included. So my value of x is going to be 6. And this is going to be the probability of 0 all the way to 6 added together. So the probability of having at most 6 people is 0.1299. So maybe you can round this to 0.13. The next question, what is the probability that at least 2 people support the healthcare revision? At least 2 people. So that includes 2. So everything from 2 all the way to our maximum number, which is 20. So I'm interested in the probability of all of these things happening. Now, remember, your calculator, when you're doing CDF, can only do from 0 all the way to the value you put into. Since I'm interested from 2 all the way to the end, I'm going to need to use my calculator to find out what is the probability of getting either 0 or 1. And then I can subtract 1 to this probability to find out what is the remaining red probability. So let's try this in our calculators. Second function vars, binomial CDF, number of trials is 20. Our probability hasn't changed. I'm interested in finding the green. Now the green is from 0 to 1. So 1 is the value I'm looking for here. The probability of this happening is 1.11 times 10 to the negative 4. Super small probability of this happening, right? It makes sense because the graph had the lines that were like almost equal to 0. We couldn't even see the lines here. What I'm interested in is the probability that we have at least 2. So I'm interested in this red probability. So I know that all the probabilities added up together equal 1. So I'm going to do 1 minus, and I can just scroll up, click enter, in order to find the probability of the red. And I get that the probability of getting at least 2 is 0.9998. So you can round that to either 0.999, or you can put that to 1. Our next example, a particular clerk has a 25% chance of making a mistake on an assignment. If 8 assignments are selected from this clerk, find the probability that 2 are incorrect, and find the probability that at least 2 are incorrect. Okay, so we have a situation here where a clerk can either make a mistake or not. Binary event, good. We know the probability of making a mistake is 0.25%. So that doesn't change from mistake to mistake. It's an independent probability. And then we know how many times we're doing this experiment. So we're trying 8 times. We're trying to repeat this experiment 8 times. So the probability distribution table we can have here is all the way from 0 to 8. So we can have 0 mistakes, 8 mistakes. Now what you're noticing is that I'm always using the probability distribution graph in order to help me understand this problem. You don't need to use this graph, but I just like to do it in the early examples to have a visual of it, but it's not a necessary tool. Find the probability that 2 are incorrect. So this is the probability that exactly 2 of them are incorrect. That means I'm going to be using binomial PDF. In my calculator, second function vars, I'm finding binomial PDF. Number of trials, I have 8 assignments. The probability of making a mistake is 0.25. And I'm interested in making exactly 2 mistakes. So the probability of making exactly 2 mistakes is 0.311. B, find the probability that at least 2 are incorrect. If at least 2 are incorrect, that means I'm interested in 2 or more. I'm interested in 2 all the way to 8. Now, similarly to what we did in our first example, our calculator cannot calculate this directly. The calculator can only calculate from 0 all the way to a number. So all the way to a number, we're interested in 0 and 1. So in my calculator, I'm going to go second function vars. I'm going to binomial CDF because there's more than one number I'm interested in. Trials is 8. Probability of making a mistake is 0.25. And this x value is the biggest number I'm interested in, which is 1. And I get that the probability of pink, the probability of 0 or 1, is 0.367. Therefore, if I'm looking for the probability of having 2 or more, this is going to be 1 minus this probability. So I'm going to have a probability of 0.633. So now that we've done 2 examples with binomial PDF, CDF, and kind of using that, we're realizing that there's 2 main parameters that are important for binomial distribution. N, which is the number of trials, and P, which is the probability of success. This is the formal definition that we're going to be using to say that a variable X, a random variable, is distributed binomially. The B stands for binomially, and we're going to have a specific number of trials, and we're going to have a specific probability. So this notation here, we have to know how to use, because it could give us questions with this notation, and we have to be able to get the important information out, which is the number of trials and the probability. Let's look at this example. If X is distributed binomially, where N is equal to 11 and P is equal to 0.25, find the probability that X is between 3 and 7, including 3 and 7. So this notation, what it's telling you is that you're repeating an experiment 11 times. You're repeating a binary experiment, right? Because it's a binomial distribution. So every time you have an experiment, you have either pass or fail. You're going to have either, you're going to have a total of 11 passes, or you're going to have 0 passes, right? So the outcomes that we have are from 0 all the way to 10. 0.25, that's the probability of getting our specific success. I'm interested in finding the probability that I am between 3 and 7, including 3 and 7, as you can see from the inequality signs. We're including 3 and 7. So I'm interested in finding the probability of these bars here. So the 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, right? Adding all these together. In this distribution, there's still probability of getting 8, 9, 10, or even 11, right? There's still this probability, but they're so small that it's very unlikely here. So it's just going to be a low probability. Okay, thinking about this question here, I'm interested in the green part. So the green part from 3 to 7, well, in order to find this, I need to think about what my calculator can do for me. My calculator with binomial CDF can only calculate from 0 all the way to the specific number you're putting into. So what I'm going to have to do first is I'm going to have to find the probability that I have from 0 all the way to 7. So first I need to calculate, what is the probability of being from 0 all the way to 7? So in my calculator, I'm going to go second function vars, find my binomial CDF. Number of trials is 11, the probability of 0.25 as well for this one. And I'm going to put in the value of X, which is 7. This is going to be the probability that I'm going to be between 0 and all the way to 7. So this is going to, I'm going to round to 3 significant figures, 0.999. Next, I'm going to look at what is the probability of getting just between 0 and 2. So my calculator can do this calculation for me. What is the probability of being between 0 and 2? I'm going to do again normal binomial CDF, same trials. This time my X value is 2. The probability of this happening is 0.455. And if I'm interested in only the green section, which is from 3 to 7, what I'm going to have to do for this is I'm going to have to multiply the orange section and subtract the purple section. So I can scroll up in my calculator. This was the orange section and subtract the purple section. And I get the probability of having between 3 and 7 inclusively is 0.544. So if we sum up what we've talked about so far, we're using the calculator in order to find the probability of exactly one number occurring, or we're using the calculator to find all the numbers from 0 all the way to the number you put into your calculator. So this is for many numbers, but starting at 0 and going all the way to that number. These are the two calculator functionalities that we're going to be using, and we can only use this if we have a situation where we have a binary event happening, two choices, a fixed number of trials, and we know the probability of each of those successes are the same trial after trial.